this video, we will look at some simple tests that may be performed with a digital multimeter to check for common data logger problems. A good quality digital multimeter is an essential tool for troubleshooting electronics. It consists of several components. The digital multimeter's most visible part is its digital display. It provides clear and precise readings of the measured values. The selector knob allows you to choose the type of measurement you want to perform. It typically includes options for voltage, current, and resistance. There are two input jacks, one for the red, positive probe, and one for the black, negative probe. These jacks are where you connect the test leads. The test leads are wires with probes at the end. They connect to the digital multimeter and allow you to make contact with the circuit or component you're measuring. Make sure that your multimeter has good battery voltage before making measurements. For specific questions about your model of multimeter, refer to the documentation provided by the manufacturer. Two of the most important tests you can perform when troubleshooting a data logger are to check the 12-volt and 5-volt power output channels. The 12-volt channel voltage can tell you whether the system is receiving enough power and may help identify a problem with your power supply or an electrical short that is causing problems. The voltage on the regulated 5-volt channel can help you identify problems with communication or other data logger functions. To prepare for the measurements, push the connector for the black probe into the socket labeled COM. This is the common reference channel that is the point of comparison for your voltage readings. Next, push the connector for the red probe into the socket labeled V omega. This is a multi-purpose channel that is used to measure voltage and resistance. Finally, turn the selector knob to measure direct current or DC voltage. If your digital multimeter has user-selected voltage ranges, choose the smallest range that is greater than 18 volts. My multimeter has a range option of 20 volts, so I will select that. Now we are ready to measure voltages on the data logger's voltage output channels. Touch the black probe to the terminal screw for any channel labeled G, and the red probe to the terminal screw for the channel labeled 12V. Some data logger models don't have a 12V channel, but have an equivalent channel labeled BAT plus. The reading should match the voltage coming in from the power supply and be within the data logger's operating range. In this case, the CR1000X has an input voltage range of 10 to 18 volts, so this reading indicates that the data logger's power is okay. Next, touch the black probe to the terminal screw for any channel labeled G, and the red probe to the terminal screw for the channel labeled 5V. If your data logger doesn't have a channel labeled 5V, you can skip this test. The reading on the regulated 5-volt channel should be within 4.75 to 5.25 volts. So again, this is a good reading. If the results of these tests are within the expected range, you're ready to move on to the next troubleshooting step. If not, then you have a starting point for additional testing. Remember that you can contact support at Campbell Scientific to assist you in identifying problems or making arrangements to send equipment in for repair.